much further than a lot of other people and had several records, not only with electric, also with conventional aircraft, especially with gliders. But now he has just recently you've flown records, and there is an event coming up where you want to tell us about. So, Klaus, stage is yours.
Thank you, Willy. I'm ready. Okay, thank you, Willy. Yes, as Willy mentioned, I'm a glider pilot, and one of the reasons why I'm in electric flight is that we still have this little dirt under the fingernail. When we are flying, we need still some conventional energy, fossil energy, in order to get the minimum altitude to arrive to our gliding challenge. So this is one of the reasons why I'm involved in electric aircraft, because with electric aircraft you can charge batteries, you can use sustainable fuel, or you can even use hydrogen in the future, which is a more or less emission-free flight. So the National Aircraft Association, USA, they will make electric air race in May 2023, so next year. There's still a little time in order to participate. So if you look why they make this competition, because competition air race is always in the history of flying made a huge progress very often. So you remember probably these first challenges to cross the channel from England to France. You see here this old plane. And personally, I remember at 2011, there was a race created from NASA, the Green Flight Challenge in USA, in California. And I participated with E-Genius, which was an airplane built by Institut der Flugzeugbau in the University of Stuttgart. And they made this beautiful plane. I first met them, I think at 2010, end of 2010. They had just the wings and they had just some parts of the plane. They had to build the fuselage. And I heard about this race, which should take place 1 year after that. And I could really not imagine that it will be possible that they will finish this plane, knowing a little bit about the students, they will build a plane, so it always needs more time. It's not the same thing if Enterprise will build a plane like that. But in nearly 1 year, they finished this beautiful plane, the E-Genius, which has, as you can see here, motor, electric motor in the tail with a big propeller, and all the wings, they are more or less like a glider. So this original plane is as well a glider, a motor glider, ultralight motor glider. And so we participated at this competition, and it was even postponed 3 months because even the organization, they could not arrive to finish all the planes that should participate. We had two planes, the E-Genius, which was participating, and the Pipistrel High 4 now, this double fuselage. They won as well the race because they had four places, and the winner of the place, it was related with passenger miles. So if you have more passengers, then you will have all the consumption by passenger mile. So we had more, we had much less fuel burned, not fuel, but electricity, but they had more passengers. So anyway, so this race from the NAA It should take place from Omaha in Nebraska to Kitty Hawk, a very well-known place where the first motor flight with the Wright brothers took place. So it's a 1,000 nautical miles, nearly 2,000 kilometers in 4 days. They take into account that we have electric planes, which only can use batteries or emission-free propulsions, that will say fuel cells. You can imagine it's a real challenge, because with batteries it should be a little bit difficult. So they have a lot of airfields in between on this course, and it's free to the participant to land wherever they want, and they can charge the batteries, they can swap the batteries. There are a lot of possibilities how to do. There are a lot of ideas as well from the teams or the pilots. Shells, you can use probably a little bit more tailwind starting the next day. You take eventually the risks with the weather. But you cannot make night flights. You cannot make IFR flights due to the reason they are all more or less all prototypes. And so they don't want to take any risk for that, or I think it's even not possible to get the authorization to make this in this. So you can imagine a lot of different types of aircraft. I think we have more than 200 ongoing projects in electrifying airplanes, probably the eVTOLs, taxis, and so on. And what I like with this race is that there we will see how they fly. So you cannot hide behind your prospects and say, we are the best, we make the most fantastic things. There they have to show, it's a real showcase. And that is the sense of these competitions. So there's one plane, for example, that I think they will participate, and I think they even can win. It's depending on the logistics that they have. It's clear the Alice from Aviation would be probably the fastest plane if they will fly, if they have not technical problems, which with all prototypes you can always have. So they changed as well. The motorization, you see now they have a more classic motorization behind electric motors. Before they had propulsion set on the outer wings and in the tail of the plane. It's even possible as well, I saw the Joby was flying and still and quite fast as well. So they ask for speed only. That is the thing what about. Or we can even have some planes like this one, very interesting as well, that there is a version that is electrified from the Silence Twister, built by Matthias Stricker in Germany, a beautiful plane. The funny thing is, Matthias came from model building, and so he wanted to have a plane where he can sit in, and so for me, those who built the models, I know a lot of these guys, they are often, later they built their own plane. They are really very, very good guys to work with the materials, and they built everything themselves. They know their plane, and you see this beautiful plane. You can make acrobatics with them. This guy, it's Andy McKee, an engineer from the UK, who flew nearly around the world, and he flew to Oshkosh with this small, tiny little plane alone over the Atlantic. Fantastic. Or you can even eventually fly with this plane. That's the genius from the University of Stuttgart. And so you see them last week. We flew with this plane. When we made the green flight challenge, we flew with batteries only, so we could fly 400 kilometers. And during the times after the competition, I could make a 500 kilometer flight with this plane, using a little bit renewable energy, I admit. So the choice of the flight path was as well a little bit lifts with as I'm coming from gliding. But this is not really a glider, is he really very heavy? But of course, if you are flying along updrafts, then you will have a better range in this case. So 500 kilometers to do with the Egenius with battery powered. Here is a photo which is recent from last week. The University of Stuttgart, they changed the system. They went to a hybrid system, which I find it's really reasonable in aviation especially, because you are limited with batteries. The batteries, they are much better now, but far by far not as good to make, for example, 1,000 kilometers. So that's what we achieved with the hybrid system. So we have still the electric propulsion in the tail, but we have a smart motor which has a very low consumption of diesel fuel or kerosene in the big fuselage. So the Egenius is a research plane, and they want to make different motorizations with batteries, with combustion engine, or in the future, I'm quite sure they will make as well with fuel cells. Then they are emission free. Emission free will only say if you charge the hydrogen, which is made by electrolysis with renewable energies. Because you can take industrial hydrogen from refineries, but then it's not the same thing. It's not proper as well. So with this plane and in this configuration, last week we could make a 500 kilometer out and return world record with 207 kilometers per hour with a very low fuel consumption. And the next day we made a 1,000 kilometer flight with consumption of diesel as low as 6 liters per hour. So they have only a tiny little tank behind. It's a 36 liter tank, and you can make 1,000 kilometers with that with a speed of 170 kilometers per hour, which is quite nice for this distance. Of course, you need always to, the longer the range, the slower you have to fly. So this is after the record, the selfie that we made. You can see all the team is happy. It's important for me to mention that I do not feel that I made this world record. This is a world record of team. I try to bring in my competence as a pilot, experienced pilot in this team, but the engineers, they do the work, so they merit, you know, there's Icarus and Daedalus in the Greek mythology, and Icarus was the one who is always the hero, that's the pilot, but in reality was this guy who flew out of the flight domain and then broke his wings. I don't want to be this kind of Icarus hero, which will die, and the father, the Daedalus, who built this plane, he was the engineer, and he said, don't fly too high because the sun will burn probably the wings. So these engineers, they built that, and it's more than 10 years I worked together with them, and it's really very great. Sometimes I'm a black box man, you know, I know there's a plane, there's a motor inside, and they take sometimes the lamps and make some light in my black box, and I know a little bit more about that. That's quite nice. So you see here, I'm coming more from the gliding world. This is a beautiful electric glider, the Antares 20E from Lange Aviation. And I must say it's really wonderful. So you can charge the batteries with solar panels or with wind energy, and then you can really fly emission free. So it's still a little bit of a problem because you will start, you have limited batteries, and then of course you make your initial altitude, and then you have to take what you can as lifts, and then if ever you have a problem or you want to fly in one direction, you want to fly back, the batteries are not enough to do so, like with a combustion engine. So that is the reason why one company, engineers once again, they changed the system. They made this big motor behind the glider, behind the fuselage, which disappears after having started. They made a small little propeller here in front. The idea came from Lukas Sidnacik, who has a company, FES, Front Engine Sustainer. At the beginning, it was only a small auxiliary motor, electric motor, in order to come home, so you could not start yourself. But Advantech, Stefan Senger, engineer, they thought about this system is quite nice. The Antares has a gear which is quite high, and why we should not try to start with this plane. And that's what I could do as well last week. We made the first flight in Augsburg, where is the company is situated. And I was really amazed and very astonished with this small little prop, and with only 30 kilowatt engine, I was in the air after 300 meters and 2.5 meters climbing rate. That was very impressive for me, because I fly an Antares 20E and you have a 2 meters prop and you have 40 kilowatt the engine. Of course it climbs better, but the advantage of this system is that the consumption of the energy in the batteries, you have the batteries in the wings, and they are just filling now the batteries, and when it's ready, we have 80 kilos of batteries, and then we have a range, in relatively slow flight, of course, of 450 kilometers. And this is really a game changer, for my kind of flight, because I'm living in southern France, and I really like to fly to the Pyrenees, I like to fly to Italy, in the Alps, and there you can make, usually use only for 500 meter climb, then you use thermals or wind, ridge shoring, wave, and so on. And that, but then you have something, you can still make 400 kilometers to go somewhere where you want, if the weather conditions does not allow to continue the flight in gliding. This is another project that I have to make battery-driven flight, but they do not stop as well, because we have the same problem that I mentioned before with batteries, only you have not the same range. So then they use, where the actually the motor is situated behind, they use as a small port where you can take something in when you take this motor out, and they use a Wankel engine, a small Wankel engine there in order to charge the batteries, in order to fly. And then the range will be more than 2,000 kilometers in slow flight. Why is that so? Because the airframe of the glider has the best efficiency anyway, and all electric planes which want to have a lot of range, they need a very efficient airframe which comes close to a glider. They need smooth surfaces, they need probably a little bit more wingspan than usually. It makes no sense if you make you electrify a Cessna, which is very heavy, which has a dramatic aerodynamic efficiency, so that makes no sense. So this plane I'm really hoping to fly, because it's the closest to a glider. But I have another project, I have a lot of projects, I will tell you the projects of the next 5 years that I have. So my other plane is, or glider, is this beautiful construction from the Stemme AG. Dr. Rainer Stemme made this beautiful plane, and you will see a little bit in the animation then how that works. So it's a wingspan of 23 meters, like some other planes. The performance is from 30 years ago, but it's still very good. And the advantage of this plane is that he has a huge fuselage. It's a side-by-side glider, and there you can see how it works normally. So you have a Rotax engine behind in the fuselage, in a tube cage. This engine is behind the pilots, and the carbon tube which is going to the propeller in front. So here you see a little bit animation how that works. So you open the kind of the dome of the glider mechanically, and then you start the engine, and you see the prop disappears this system. So you see it. Oh, sorry, you see it. Does it go back? Yes, I'll try once again. Oh, it doesn't work, but that, never, doesn't mind. So you see the construction, you see this tube carrier behind the two pilots. You see in front the engine compartment for electric engine. And I have to say, I'm really very happy. I had a very good engineer, which I met on a fly-in in Grenchen 2 years ago. And he made a speech about his electric system. It's Carl Pickham. He explained how he transferred a glider from a combustion engine to an electric plane. And I was amazed about the techniques that he used. It was really a very clean concept. And I asked him after the presentation, I see, hello, presented me and said, can you imagine to build this system in a stemmer glider? And he answered, that's what I always wanted. So we made our private project, Stemmer S10 E-Flight. And there you can see we have the motor system on the right-hand side. You see the electronic stuff and make the motor work. And then you can see this is a MREX motor, very nice motor, which has a lot of improvements there. And you see as well the prop. Actually, we will use a fixed prop, so we have not a real very good glider because this prop will stay outside. But in the future, we will use as well a FES system, which is the propeller along the fuselage. You lose a little bit performance of the glider, but it's not that much. And the system is very simple, very easy compared to other systems where you take out probably a combustion engine behind and it needs some time. It's the electric motors. The more systems you have, the more risk you have that you have a failure. So this is the system. We made the nose a little bit longer, and my engineer works with the University of Trier, and they had two young students. They made this nice presentation, by the way, and you see what they wanted to do at first. They learned how to scan a glider. They made a reconstruction and the digital construction with then after that the model for the new cowling in front, because the nose of the plane will be a little bit longer and a little bit more aerodynamics. And so that was their work, their start. They start here with the scanning. It was cold in winter time, but they did their job. And then they made a digital model of that, and that it was beautiful. So they could, all the construction, now they could do it in the computer at first, and you do not need to try and error and then try to adapt the system. You know everything before, how that works. So you see the system where the prop is fixed before, the nose dome is away, and this was the former dome where they made scans as well. So I do not know exactly. I learn always a little bit, but for me it's still black box. I'm amazed always about this engineering that they make. So they made a new construction of cone. And so it's a lot of work for students. They do not know as well, so they learn the systems. And so I think they are quite happy to have a approved engineer who knows how to do this and that. And my friend Carl, I'm amazed as well, because he knows all these new construction tools, even if he is more than 60 years old. That's fantastic to see. So I will tell you not too much about that, because probably I will tell you not the truth. So these are the construction tools, and here you see the new cowling that we will have to cover all this motor stuff. You see the nose is a little bit longer, and so we have not this egg, we have a more round situation here for the cowling. It was not 100% round symmetric, but it's still enough. It works with other gliders as well. You have a little egg as well, but it still works. So you see these tools, what you can do. Oh yeah, I'm always amazed, these nice animations you can see. That's the normal stuff that all the engineers, they know nowadays. And this is the fixed propeller that we have. You see the former connections here from the dome, and then the new cowling with a little bit more pointed nose with a new prop, which is a high efficient props from Ultralights. It's just beside where I'm living. A company which is as well here, eProps called, and they made very high efficient props. They have now a new propeller with, what is it in English? Changing the I'm spinning between the pitch things. I'm working between French, German, and English. So they have a new system which is very interesting, very light. So the advantage of this prop is that he has only 2.5 kilos, and that allows us to use the bearings of the electric motor, the MRAX motor. Normally, if you have a heavier prop, then you need a special bearing in front, and all this is weight. And my engineer, he says we want to push the weight the lowest if it's possible, but in a safe way, of course. Nehmen wir den richtigen. So it's just to show a little bit how they worked and how well they worked, finally. So they made as well, and of course it's as well a question of cost, because it's a private project. I cannot afford 500,000 euros for a construction like that. That's the reason why I say, okay, I want to make something, what I have to do, then I can do it. And so the university, they have the tools, so they made this form, and then you see how it works for those who have no idea, like I had, how that works, and it's a digital model, and then they make the positive model for that, and after that the cowling is then done. And here you see on the stemmer the new cowling, the nose is longer, and it's I think it's a little bit more aerodynamic. It's a pity that I cannot make an aero tool, because there's no aero hook on this plane. And if not, I would compare with other stemmers how this new nose will work. But anyway, I think it's a good way for the prop, because the airflow along the fuselage is not the same like you have a Cessna or something like that, where half of the current of the propeller, the flow, is against an obstacle, yeah, and makes a lot of turbulences. When the airflow along the glider is nice, then the pushing forward is, well, quite much better. So this is a little bit construction of the spinner. You see, they are really professional in what they do. If I regret one thing in my life, I was, when I started gliding, I was in an aero club in Braunschweig, but just beside there were the Ackerfliegs, and they made a lot of constructions themselves, and so they learned a lot of things during their studies, but at that time I was not a student, I was just at school, so I could not go in the Ackerflieg. So you see here what is a little bit new. So I forgot to mention that Carl, my engineer, made a very special cooling stuff here. The airflow inside of the cowling is orientated to the motor in order not to use probably the liquid cooling. So we have a combined cooling, but we try it first if we can use it only with the air, because that less weight, less complicated for the adaption of a cooling, liquid cooling. And you see behind, we have a lot of space where actually the Rotax is, and there we can use the space for batteries and as well for a little motor. So the connections with my friend Carl allowed us to get a specialist for motors. So what is the reason why this motor is so small? It's an industrial motor. The consumption with maximum power is 6 liters per hour, and that the energy, the generator, you see the generator here, it's as well electric motor, and the whole genset is probably less than 40 kilos. What we have usually in a normal plane, you have a big motor in order to start, and we do not need this big motor during the cruise, so it's always a compromise. And I think we will have 20 kilos, despite we use batteries as well, probably 40, up to 40 to 50 kilos batteries to have the boost for the start. And then in flight, the electric energy, which is generated by this small little motor, will make the cruise. And I think with the 120 liters that I have in my wings, I will have a range of probably 3,000 kilometers. So it's a more a problem of your backside than other things, because when you make a big flight, it's for sure, I know my glider flights usually are 15 hours in a plane. Okay, in a plane you have a little bit more time, you can fly, you have not to make all 2 minutes a decision where to go, because to handle your energy in order to stay alive or in the air. Yeah, this is my project that I want to have actually, and hopefully we can fly even this year. It depends as well a little bit of the paperwork, because you cannot just have an idea and you build a plane and then you fly with that. You need to integrate that with the authorities. But I think we are in a good way, because it's really a very good system and a very good engineering for what I want to do. Yeah, you ask probably why I will do all that. So now we have a combustion engine and I use fossil fuel probably more than I do with my glider flights. But my opinion is, with the situation that we have actually concerning our climate, we need to do everything at the same moment and not just waiting for future technology that will change our climate in 10, 15 years. We need to do it now. Probably the costs are higher. We need to use sustainable aviation fuel. That's just one thing that we can do quite fast. We need to use the renewable energy at their whole potential. That will say, if we make sustainable aviation fuel, or in the future as well, hydrogen with electrolysis, wind energy is as well there in the night, not the photovoltaic, but the photovoltaic we have in summer, we can transform it into gas, in hydrogen, or in sustainable aviation fuel. But of course, we still make a little bit with combustion engine, we will have some exhaust and CO2. That is the reason why I have other projects, and there I would like to tell you something about the hydrogen fuel cell flights. In the hangar A7, you find all the planes I mentioned here. This is Atos Group, and they have a really wonderful concept, and they are quite close to fly. They hope to fly at the end of next year. And this is just a small plane with 4 seats, and they have ranges. I have to look a little bit closer than I don't. So the cruise could be 160 knots. And you can, with 400 kilo, that allows you with 4 passengers. The range is 500 nautical miles, and 16,000 feet. So this is a little bit something like you have in conventional planes, but this plane is really emission-free if the hydrogen is built up with the photovoltaic or renewable energies. So, of course, this is more a test system, and if you have a look for these planes, they are much more interesting, I find, from the zero emission and from the general, not from a commercial aviation aspect. He will make as well these flights, and there he can make 1.5 ton. The very interesting thing with this plane is that he has the spare in the wing. The spare is at the same time the hydrogen storage. So, and he has then the space for passenger and for load, payload, that you can see. Interesting I2, you can see it as well on the A7. This is, from my opinion, one of the most advanced projects, and I had always a feeling where it's interesting, and I'm interested to make a showcase out of these planes and to show. I hope to fly in 2024 with an emission-free plane around the world. I think this is possible, and it is important to do such things. Just to finish with this climate discussion, I'm always a little bit worried about why do we need always fear as a motivation for people? Yeah. So everybody say, you know, next year you will die if you don't change something. Politics, they are doing that very often, working with fear. We could see it in a pandemic, we can see it with the climate. And most of you, they have a nice smartphone somewhere, and I don't believe that you will buy a smartphone when somebody is with a baseball stuff and say, if you don't buy it, I will kill you. No. We buy it because we are amazed, we are motivated, and all people are motivated. Fear is manipulation. Marketing is manipulation. Education is manipulation. It depends always the sense that you give. And I want to make a showcase. I want to try to show these beautiful technologies that can help us. We will go out of this crisis, I'm convinced, but only with technology and people, they are motivated and they're thinking about to do amazing things and to make a better life in the future. So that's my idea. Thank you for you for your attention. If there are any questions, feel free. No questions, so you are convinced what I said. Thank you for your attention.
How can you get eFly Journal? Just scan the QR code on this page. Or just type in your browser www.eflightjournal.com. Then you receive the page with the latest online news on electric flying, eVTOLs, and everything which is connected with electric mobility in the air. Or you can click the link on the top, and then you go to the latest PDF version, which you either can read in the Yumpu reader directly on your screen, like a conventional magazine, or you can go and download the magazine as PDF file so that you can read it offline wherever you want. Thanks for watching and goodbye.
3.